Welcome back to the Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade, and there is our Rose of Tralee, Nancy.
Who's that guy on the left?
Our Who is Jim that? Foreman.
Well, he gets that the good job every year.
The escort?
Behind the rose is her court this year. Beautiful girls with all the tears in their eye, which is Shamrock Queen. Sheila Dudash and...
And there is the Queen's Court. We're going to get a chance to talk to our Rose of Tralee here in a minute. Let's listen to this group, Nancy. They're terrific. Well, terrific band, another terrific band. Nancy Duffy, you have got a very, very special guest with you who we are very happy to have.
Yes, I am with a munchkin from the Wizard of Oz 50 years ago. It's Mr. Robbie, who came from Florida. And tell me, have you ever been in anything like this before?
I don't believe I've ever been in a parade with quite this a large crowd of tenors, particularly the children. In other words, I'm really amazed at the number of children you've had here and the crowd in general.
Well, really, we're saluting you, you know. The whole parade is for the wee people.
Well, thank you. That's why when I first came in and saw the wee people, I was wondering how many wee ones you had around.
And tell me, what part did you play in the Wizard of Oz?
I was the Munchkin Coroner that officially pronounced the Wicked Old Witch dead.
And what did you say?
As coroner, I must have her. I thoroughly examined her, and she's not only merely dead, she's really most sincerely dead.
And of course, you were with the Chitnango people.
That's right.
On their float.
That's correct.
And they're having a big Oz Day celebration next May.
That's correct. And hopefully I can participate.
Oh, that would be wonderful. You might come back.
I hope so.
That's great. Well, again, you are Mr. Robbie and one of our honorary leprechauns today.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much.
Nancy Duffy and Meinhard Robbie from The Wizard of Oz, and we thank him so much for being here today. He's been delightful.
There's
the Irish potatoes.
Look at this.
Something just been thrown up to us now. Here we are.
What's it say?
From O'Connor Insurance, the original potato people. There we are.
I like
it. Camera shot somewhere up there. Thanks so much. I think we have some more.
I got more. Here you go.
And now from Kingston, the International Youth Year, and of course,
representing the Bristol Myers Company.
They are the Empire Loyalists, Junior Drum and Bugle Corps, Charlie Cadu. Every year, we hear from the Empire Loyalists.
And let's hear from them now.
Still working there, huh?
Empire Loyalists, it's led by drum major Miss Becky Carroll, and they've won many first place trophies, and from that presentation you know why. Here are our friends from Bristol Myers Company of Syracuse. Over 1,000 employees of Bristol Myers Company located in Syracuse. Proud of being part of Syracuse's community for 45 years, and we're happy to have them in this parade.
They're accustomed to the color green because they
sure
are. Kind of still in there. Matter of fact,
right?
Well, Nancy Duffy, yet another leprechaun.
Well, we're inundated here.
This is the only official leprechaun
of the whole country.
Of the whole country. Is that not right? Brian Stark, who is the Notre Dame leprechaun, the Fighting Irish mascot.
Hello, Nancy. How's everything going up here?
Well, it's great. Now, how come you came to our parade?
Well, I, as you know, St. Patrick's Day is certainly a popular time for leprechauns all around the world. And I got invitations from a number of different cities, including Chicago and San Diego and some pretty warm places. But I picked the warmest of them all, Syracuse, New York, because it's the warmth of people's hearts and the friendship that's here that made me want to come here.
And you had a lot of fun last night.
We had a great time. I couldn't believe this celebration they throw in Syracuse. I never knew there were that many Irish people here.
And you usually have a pot of gold. What happened to your pot of gold?
Well, I think the pot of gold has been emaciated by a number of the wee people here.
Okay, you are a student at Notre Dame.
Yes, I am. I'm a senior this year.
And you had a tryout for this.
It's a tryout every year. Very competitive.
Very competitive. How many people tried out for it this year?
Last year, I think there were about 22 people. And each year, there's usually quite a few. It's an honored position at our school.
Okay, well, I'm going now to someone very close to you from Chicago, Peggy Finnegan, who once even was a runner-up for the Rose of Tralee.
That's right.
And Peggy Finnegan is out on this parade route. And, of course, the leprechauns are out in the street, too. Did you ever see so many in your life?
No. In fact, when the parade got together this morning, I was wondering who was going to watch the parade. There are so many people in this parade. It's great. They must import them from all over New York. It's really wonderful.
And you had the Notre Dame Club with you, too.
That's right. I was on the Notre Dame float, in fact, the Notre Dame Club of Syracuse and this area in New York. It was really nice.
Okay, and now we'll go to Peggy Finnegan.
Thanks, Nancy. You know, this is the best place to be, right here on the street, because when there's a lull in the parade, there's always some entertainment going on. Listen here and you'll see the Gulf Line Road neighbors who come here every year, and all they do is sing and entertain. And I think Mike Price wants to join them. Go ahead.
No, this is your act, Peg, but I just enjoy the singing. I just want to sing along.
We'll go back to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Young Rascals.
Thanks, Peggy.
Okay, we had just seen the Dogs of Ireland walk by, and some wonderful dogs all dressed up with green bows.
Hey, there's Michael O. Jackson.
And he's doing some kind of an Irish jig, I guess.
Well, here come the Rascals.
Oh, and these are classic. If you notice, they have the oldest members up front with their ages around their neck.
I know where our director in the truck is going to get a shot of those ages on the front.
Look at that.
And they weren't sure that all of the Rascals were going to make it, but they are all here. And there's Lou McKenna and Jake Costello. We'll miss a few along the way.
From Baldwinsville, Bridgewater's Dog Training School.
The old Rascals, of course, are headed by Nellie Mahar. There's Nibs Ryan. Nibsy's Ryan's is quite a classic place on the west side.
How you doing, everybody?
And they have their traditional float, you see.
Gee, what is that?
For the old Rascals, that's an appropriate float.
Last year, they took up residence in the Crown Hotel during the parade.
Some of the younger Rascals, I presume, at the rear.
And here comes some more dogs, the Bridgewater Dogs, which is a new dog group in the parade this year. And looks like puppies in those baskets they have.
Well, actually, Nancy,
Oh.
The Bridgewater Dogs have a lot of pride, of course, and they show their dogs all over the state and in Canada in obedience competitions.
They're certainly very well-mannered. Look at, they're better than some of our marching groups. Look at how
very,
orderly.
Very well-behaved.
Very behaved. I'm very impressed with
that
this dog.
Says a lot for the dog training school of Bridgewater, that's for sure.
German Shepherds and Shetland Sheepdogs.
And look at that cute little one coming up in the end. That's a wee one.
That's a wee. He's pulling that truck.
Well, we
you
have,
don't notice it, but he's pulling that truck.
We have wee people and wee dogs.
Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, our float judges today.
It's terrific to see Maynard, Robbie, and Brian Stark.
Bishop Joseph O'Keefe.
What terrific ovations they got at the review last night.
They certainly did. And, of course, Joe Carcione, the greengrocer, was around earlier, and his cousin, who has the same name from North Salina Street, is runs the Cafe d'Italia and hasn't seen him in many years. Came down to the parade to see the greengrocer.
We can't promise you anything, but perhaps the Joe Carcione, the greengrocer, will be able to stop by our broadcast position here later on. You saw again there scenes of the crowd on Salina Street, and we say this all the time, but it is continuing to grow. I think folks have taken our advice and have made their way to the parade route.
There's Brian Stark, the Notre Dame Leprechaun.
He did a jump and a flip off the stage last night that was incredible. Young man with boundless energy and represents Notre Dame University very, very well.
Ladies and gentlemen,
another pipe band, Nancy.
Would you welcome, please,
one of our 25, or 15.
Fraser Highlanders of Avon, New York.
Always a favorite.
And a champion band.
They'll be marching into position here in just a few minutes. They are, of course, regulars at parades, festivals, commencements. 1977, pipe band competitions all throughout U.S. and Canada. Let's listen.
And followed by the Burn Dairy Floats, the pony-drawn milk wagon. Four mules with covered wagon, a new milk truck, several marchers passing out chocolate, mint milk, half pints.
Fraser's Highlanders Band. And we'll continue with more of Central New York 9's live coverage of the 6th annual St. Patrick Parade from downtown Syracuse right after these important messages.
And it's a great day for fans.
Be gosh, there's not a cop to stop parading. Be gosh.
ET Video, entertainment to go. You'll find the largest selection of movies in Central New York in both VHS and Beta formats. Check the new ET Video Guide. Most children's films are just 93 cents a day. ET has Nintendo game cartridges for sale or rent. ET is the source for all your audio and video needs. Cameras, large screen TVs, camcorders, and VCRs. All for sale or rent. ET Video is entertainment to go. Liverpool, North Syracuse, Brewerton, Mexico, and in Williams Grocery.
You're on your way financially. You found a place where you'd like to be.
Get into shape, the time is now. Let Merchants Bank show you how. You're ready for fiscal fitness. You'll find it at Merchants Bank. The time is now. We'll show you how. We're first in fiscal fitness, Merchants Bank.
Well, boom. One of us has to say something. I think we're on the air. And welcome back to the Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade, everyone. I'm Jeff Scheidecker, along with Nancy Duffy, who not only is part of our Channel 9 family, but also the parade founder and president of the parade committee. Terrific job.
And I'm feeling it right now. I just think that it's all worth it. you know.
Rick Gehry is with us, and you have a very, very special guest.
I have this year's parade queen, Maureen Margaret Kelleher. How are you?
I'm fine.
You've enjoyed the parade so far?
I've had the time of my life here today.
This is exciting to be a queen of a parade, and especially an event like this, which has gotten so large and so huge in Central New York.
Yes.
Have you ever been in any other types?
No,
of...
No, I haven't. This has been my first time.
That's a good shout-out. You've done a nice job. Fantastic. This is nice. Everybody's in your fur coats and the whole thing.
Oh, they went to the extremes for me.
Well, that's nice. I think that's nice. You know, of course, we were expecting a lot colder weather, I think.
I know, but it turned out beautiful today.
Very nice. You've had your escort over here, Mr.
Yes.
James Foreman. Has he been good to you?
He's been super to me.
Excellent.
He really has.
You're going to West Tennessee High School.
Yes, I'm a senior.
You're a senior. What are you going to do with your plans next year?
I plan on going away to college next year. I'm not quite sure where.
Anything in particular that interests you?
Possibly a business major.
Mm-hmm.
Accounting.
Very good. Well, enjoy the rest of the parade, of course.
Thank you. I'm sure I will.
Okay. All right. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. All right. There's our queen.
Maureen Margaret Kelleher. Here's another band. The Lafayette Community Band.
The Lafayette Community Band. Did you get that in there, Jeff?
I sure did.
All
their
right.
Fourth year here at the St. Patrick's Parade, made up of all ages and professions, and they work very, very hard to make their music enjoyable for all of us in Central New York, not just the folks in Lafayette.
And sponsored by the Bonton and Syracuse Glass Company.
Run off the tracks in this weather. Okay.
And the James Square Nursing Home.
And now the floor droppers at Ambrosio Gritty Saloon.
And the folks from James Square have decorated their van with an Irish rainbow.
They were told to come late.
And how about some folks on snowmobiles? Specifically, how about Snoopy on a snowmobile from the Onondaga County Snowmobile Association?
Ladies and gentlemen, from Schenectady, New York.
And they try to promote an integrated trial system, a trail system throughout the county for snowmobilers. And upgrading the snowmobiler's image is their task. And they're doing a fine job at representing themselves well here in Central New York.
And here comes the Schenectady Pipe Band. And they come all the way from Schenectady every year. And they're wonderful pipers, champions. Let's listen to them.
Is that Roy Rogers?
No.
Old Bob Barker, ladies and gentlemen. Bob Barker's hot dog. And his Golden Palomino Golden Star. And that's the message to them. Syracuse
J.C.'s. Founded in 1917, the Schenectady Pipe Band has now over two dozen members, growing.
Featuring a rainbow of
Pipe Band is one of the oldest in North America. There's Bob Luongo with his beautiful stallion.
Known as Bob Barker. Bob Barkers.
Bob's the hot dog king.
Barkers.
hot dogs.
Who I think has found a terrific idea for the winter. Moved indoors to the galleries.
Yes.
And we'll be back out on the streets of downtown Syracuse once again.
Great hot dog. And there, of course, is the Syracuse JC's Rainbow of Hope for Muscular Dystrophy.
And once again this year, involved in the MDA fundraising efforts, which will culminate with Central New York Nine's participation in the Jerry Lewis Telethon on Labor Day. Terrific job that they do.
And so we've now completed three of our eight divisions.
Oh, and look at Romney, the elephant, the zoo elephant. And, of course, I was around the staging area earlier, and they were keeping Romney in a mobile gas station, John Sachs Mobile, in the wet wash. And it was just room enough. And the
10 years old, smallest elephant at the zoo, only 5,000 pounds.
And have you ever seen Chuck Doyle look so great, the elephant boy?
Looks great.
In those tuxedos, those folks just look terrific.
Donated by Centaurs.
Well, here we are, Nancy, in Division 4.
Division 4, we're halfway, at the halfway mark right now.
And we're at the halfway mark of our scheduled broadcast, and Division 4 led by the American Celtic Pipes.
And of course, the American Celtic Pipes are from Long Island.
Babylon, New York. And we'll listen to them as they pass in review.
Now the contingent from St. Elizabeth Ann Seton Church in Baldwinsville, New York.
American Celtic Pipe Band certainly doing a great job entertaining the huge crowd here in downtown Syracuse. And I wonder if Peggy Finnegan can see Finnegan's farm.
Is that her farm?
Well, I think her farm may be a little bit bigger than that, but certainly some wee people on it today.
I think she sees it.
They're from St. Elizabeth Ann Seton Church, the newest church in the diocese.
And perhaps Finnegan's Farm refers to the pastor, Father John Finnegan.
And now the Peggy. KC's against Dystrophy. Afloat the
Father John,
Shamrocks against Dystrophy.
And his
sponsored
flock.
By the New York State KC's to benefit the MDA.
Channel 9's coverage of the Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade is brought to you in part by PNC. When it comes to saving you money on your overall food bill, the price champion wrote the book. The Downtown Committee, where good things continue to happen. And Merchants Bank, let merchants get you in top financial shape. Live coverage continues after these messages.
And here it is, it's the case. And there's a girl who used to swing down by the garden gate. She and with all of the neighbors and kissed the colleagues all. Here's welcome at the garden gate.
PNC presents The Big Book of Savings, a step-by-step guide to lower overall prices. Step 2. Price breaks.
We buy in huge quantities to take advantage of special manufacturers' allowances. Then, we pass the savings on to you. Every time we get a break, you get a break. A PNC price break.
When it comes to saving you more on your overall food bill,
we wrote the book.
PNC Price Champion.
Great rewards always come from giving it your best. That's understood around the world and at your local True Value hardware store, where you'll find the powerful Eureka Upright Vacuum with 7-piece tool set. It's a 40th anniversary special for only $99.95. Or get this Munchkin personal size microwave oven by Sharp. And make True Value hardware your store of first choice.
Welcome back to the 1988 St. Patrick's Parade, We the People. Brought to you in part by Wegmans, where every day you get our best for less. Onondaga Beverage, distributor of Guinness and Harp imported Irish beer. Falso Heating, serving Central New York for over 100 years. ET Video, ET Video is entertainment to go, your headquarters for home entertainment. Merchants Bank, let merchants get you in top financial shape. And by Puffs, Puffs Plus, first aid for your nose.
And the American Red Cross.
Good. And that was the Fraser Highlander Pipe Band. I think they had a problem. Their bus broke down, and they have arrived. They're from Whitby, Ontario.
Adirondack Pipe Band from South Glens Falls, New York.
Here is another of those antique fire trucks that we're so proud of from State Farm Insurance, the sponsor of the Fraser Highlanders. Welcome back to our broadcast, everyone. Jeff Scheidecker,
ladies
along with Nancy Duffy and Rick Gehry. About midway through our planned broadcast with you. And just enjoying it. It's a terrific day. We have another pipe band coming into view now.
Yes, this is the Adirondack Pipe Band.
And let's listen to them.
Ladies and gentlemen, the very talented young lady.
And that pipe band started in 1949. There's Salty Sam. The Adirondack Pipe Band, as I said, started in 1949. They're based on the 42nd Highlanders that fought in the French and Indian Wars at Ticonderoga.
It's run by a doctor, Dr. Harold Kirkpatrick from Glens Falls.
And he certainly has the cure for any blues that you might have on a St. Patrick's Parade weekend. Here's Salty Sam.
Very good.
In the Frank Bosco float, which is the elbow room, a tradition. Oh, there they are now, the Butler Academy of Irish Dance. They've been dancing all the way down the street.
Again, another one of the acts that was on review last night at the hotels at Syracuse Square and just thrilled the crowd. Their beautiful red and white and black costumes.
Jeff, you can't imagine the intensity of the training for these girls and their travel schedule, because they compete all over the Northeast.
From Ithaca, New York, the Thunderbolt Marching Corps, directed by Tom Peterson.
From Butler Academy, the Butler Irish Dancers. And they will be very, very busy this week, entertaining.
That's right.
As we really today begin the celebration of our St. Patrick's holiday. And your parade, Nancy, and I say your parade, I know there are many people that helped put this parade on, but the parade has really begun the celebration of the holiday three or four days earlier.
And you know, it started on March 12th, 1983, exactly 6 years ago today. And it was the first time there was a long St. Patrick's holiday. It started on a Saturday and went right straight through till Thursday.
Here's the Thunderbolt Marching Corps from Ithaca, our friends to the Southern Tier. Let's listen and watch.
All right. Marching Corps from Ithaca.
They've been together for 10 years. They consist of drummers and baton twirlers and flag throwers and rifle spinners and singers and dancers and acrobats. They do just about everything. Let's watch this young man with his baton. Now, Rick, wouldn't you love to do that?
Well, I have to tell you this, Jeff, it was either that or broadcasting for me.
Representing the fine city of Ithaca, New York, the Thunderbolt Marching Corps.
Now the float from the New
York. And we have now from the Office of New York State Parks and Recreation and Historic Preservation, who are, of course, wearing the green all year.
Activities.
And this, of course, is Armin Magnarelli's float, because he's the regional director now, the state parks.
He's up on top, folks.
You have to include, of course, in there the senior games, Empire State games, and games for the physically challenged. Some of the things the Office of Parks and Recreation and Historic Preservation.
And not only that, Rick, but some of the finest, absolutely the finest state parks anywhere in the United States.
Oh, bar none. You're right.
And there is Armin Magnarelli in green. Former Common Council President.
Ready to play a little golf.
Yeah, he just gave the sign.
There's the shot of the reviewing stand where
the Teen Institute.
The Notre Dame Leprechaun has now joined. What a beautiful float that is from State Parks. And there are some more balloons being launched into the sky over our St. Patrick's Parade.
Now from the Syracuse City School District. The float from the Central Tech Vocational Center.
Just mightily impressed once again this year. This parade is just fantastic.
It gets bigger and better, and you wonder, you know, what it's going to be 10 years from now. Right, Nancy?
That's when Rick Gehry said he volunteered to take it over.
I could not even come close to what you do in a year's time to get this organized. It is just phenomenal, and I wish people could see these books and the work that you go through. And I come into work in the afternoon, and you've been there since the morning hours, and you're there when I leave at night. It's incredible. You're a bundle of energy.
It's M&M candies, you know, the M&M company.
What happened to those this year? They disappeared from your desk office.
Another one of those terrific floats. It's a green world after all from Central Tech Vocational Tigers.
And a very good aggregation on board that float.
And here's one of our new Salt City trolleys from the city of Syracuse. Of course, the Salt City trolleys were purchased by the city late last year, ushering in an era of nostalgia reminiscent of the decades when those trolleys regularly rode down the streets of Syracuse. That was the way to get on before there was the Central bus line and when the train still ran through downtown Syracuse. The trolley fare is just one thin dime, and Mayor Tom Young in the city of Syracuse, of course, invites you to take a ride on the trolley. And Rick, you know that seat's 21 and stands 24. And it's already green, so they didn't have to do anything for it for this holiday.
And of course, the trolley was used this morning to take all the VIPs from the Mass.
There's Honey Bear, the Winterfest polar bear. And we'll be back with more of the Central New York 9 coverage of the annual St. Patrick's Parade right after this.
Your energy bills with a new Carrier central air conditioner or heat pump. Buy now with no down payment. Pay later. How much later? June? No. July? No. Not even August. You don't have to pay till after Labor Day. Then choose convenient monthly terms or pay the full amount with no interest charges. A limited time offer. Call today.
Call Falso Heating now for a free estimate. No payment until October.
One more wipe and it's going to fall off.
My nose is sore.
Sore from rubbing it constantly.
Introducing First Aid for your nose when it's sore from too much blowing. New Puffs Plus.
There's something in it. I can feel the lotion in it. Lotion. Lotion in a tissue.
It's the first tissue with moisturizing lotion. New Puffs Plus.
My nose thanks you for Puffs Plus.
Puffs Plus is much less irritating than my tissue.
That's exciting when you've got a sore nose all the time.
My nose is very happy.
Welcome back to the annual St. Patrick's Parade, live from downtown Syracuse. I'm Jeff Scheidegger, along with Nancy Duffy and Rick Gehry, and it's just been a wonderful day, and the parade continues as we look at the folks from Holy Family Church passing by.
Is that a...
I think it is.
A green cow? What do you think?
Is that a cow or is it a green groundhog? I couldn't tell what it was.
Well, it's the Care Bear. That's what it is.
Right.
I was waiting for you folks to figure out.
I didn't see
it. It's a green Care Bear holding a parchment saying, "We the people at Holy Family Care." And here another one of our great dancing groups, Nancy.
The Murphy Dancers, and Meg Graves, their teacher.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Sherburn, New York, the Sherburn Oville High School Band.
You know, you may be wondering why everyone else is wearing green and these folks are wearing pink and purple. That is the Dancers of Murphy's Colors. 8-year-old school. Edward Murphy Jr., a former 2-time world champion dancer, is the teacher.
Here, of course, is the Sherburn Earlville High School Band. And a present from the Murphy Dancers. Thank you.
Sherburn Earlville High School Band. Gary Solomon, director.
from Video Memories, Roland Disc Sound in Syracuse. Professional videographers. They're putting you on tape right now.
Company gave, but they're left in my car, so.
The Sherburne Earlville High School Band hosts the largest band pageant in New York State. That's the Pageant of Bands, Nancy. That's June 4th this year. If you want to see some fantastic marching bands, head down to Sherburne Earlville, and they'll have 40 junior and senior high school bands.
It passes everything.
Followed by the Video Memories, Whirlin' Dish Sound, which, of course, are the corporate sponsors.
And, well, I don't know. Rick, how do you describe this thing?
It looks like a big tractor, but, oh, it's a monster tractor. It's from Pepsi, and this...
And from Bill O. Scott Olds, I believe. It's a... It is literally, folks, you can't feel this at home, but it's shaking the street.
Now, what do you use that for, Jeff?
Well, there are competitions, of course, every year at the War Memorial at the State Fairgrounds. These vehicles drive over and crush cars and stand on two wheels and do all kinds of things. And I'll tell you, you'd never get stuck in the mud of an Irish garden with one of those. A Star Monster. From Pepsi and Bill Scott Olds. Or Bill Scott Lincoln Mercury Mercor, I'm sorry.
Always well represented in our parade.
Here, of course, is the beginning of Division 5, which is like a mini Memorial Day parade. We have different color guards from the various American Legion posts from throughout the area coming up in our Division 5.
And another one of those terrific pipe and drum corps coming up, Nancy. Continentals from Camden. We'll be seeing them shortly.
And there again is the Pioneer Telephone Clowns. Every year they act as our marshals in front of each division.
And there are the Continentals, the oldest pipe and drum corps in New York State.
The Continentals, the oldest pipe and drum corps
also played at, get this folks, President Grant's inauguration. They were organized in 1850.
Wow.
And still going strong.
Oh.
And that woke a few people up. A cannon blast to signal the beginning of their program, and I think we'll be able to listen to them shortly.
I think I'll put my teeth back in my head now, aren't you?
The voice you may be hearing in the background before we can hear the pipe and drum corps is Rod Wood, who maybe we can get to come over here later.
Is everybody ready?
Here are the Continentals.
Raise your hand if you're freezing. That's all? The Continental Pipe and Drum Corps of Camden. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Vietnam veterans.
Here we have from the chapter 103 of the Vietnam Veterans of America.
The U.S. Coast Guard's there.
And the color guard is formed of veterans of all the armed forces who fought in the Vietnam combat situation. Organization composed of men and women who served their country during the Vietnam War. And Mike Price's favorite, the U.S. Coast Guard and their color guard and boat.
Still to come are the Mummers, what everyone is waiting for, the wonderful Sterling String Band from Philadelphia. They're up getting dressed in the Clinton Exchange.
So they're here.
They are here. They had a transportation
we'll
problem,
shortly.
But they are here.
It's another one of our Legion bands.
Liverpool Legionnaires.
American Legion Post 188 from Liverpool. Post 1276.
22 members strong. Band was organized back in the early 1950s. And you have in that marching unit today many of the original members, and they're still active in the band.
And the Dunbar Post of the American Legion in Syracuse.
Live coverage of the St. Patrick's Parade is brought to you in part by New Jersey Tourism. New Jersey and you, perfect together. True Value Hardware, more than a name, it's their way of doing business. And by Puffs, Puffs Plus, first aid for your sore nose. We'll be back after these messages.
Peter Coleman here, speaking for Guinness and Harp. A lot of tradition going on. A lot of tradition this 17th. These are the real items. 10 million glasses consumed each day. How can that many people be wrong? Guinness and Harp, the only way to go. Ireland in a glass. Schlanta.
Guinness Stout and Harp Lager, distributed to your favorite pubs and retailers by Owasco Beverage Corporation.
O is for the outstanding selection. A is for the amazing prices. K is knowing you bought the best quality. Altogether, they spell Oak from Big Sur Water Baths. We made a special purchase of this Lemoyne wall unit with center mirror and handsome twin pier cabinets for just $699.99. Or the Sutton Oak water bed is just $299.99. Add the matching dresser, mirror, and nightstand for $499. For real Oak value, it's Big Sur Water Baths. Just one more reason why we're America's largest.
And welcome back to the St. Patrick's Day Parade, 6th annual St. Patrick's Day Parade in downtown Syracuse, live coverage from Central New York 9. I'm Rick Gehry, along with Nancy Duffy and Jeff Scheidecker.
And
we have had a good time down here. The parade is moving along nicely.
Everything is moving very nicely. We are now at Division 6.
From Ontario, Canada, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, this is a returning pioneer
who is the band leader of this particular band that you see coming up. His name is Don Howell, and his father, his great-great-grandfather started cheese processing, invented cheese processing in Syracuse. They're the Lakeshore Brassmen.
Lakeshore Brassmen Senior Drum and Bugle Corps, a total of 60 marchers.
They come from a town of only 3,800 people, and it's way, way, way over in the far reaches of Ontario, Port Dover. They left early, early this morning to make it here.
None at all.
That, of course, is the OCC Noah's Ark float. Or no, the Hafner Red Barn, but it's from OCC.
OCC salutes the Irish.
The Brockville Rifles of Canada.
And next up, the Tavern on the Square from Janesville Grove.
The 113th Brockville Rifles of Canada.
And that, of course, is Tom McCabe's restaurant. And green is beautiful. All marchers will be on the float. And here come the Brockville Rifles. The Brockville Rifles and Raleigh Evans.
Here's the representatives from Fowler High School's Students Against Driving Drunk
Students
chapter.
Against Driving Drunk from throughout.
They do a terrific job. In fact, not just from Fowler, but from all of the high schools across Onondaga County. And these young people dedicate many, many hours to keeping our highways safe.
Their motto is, friends don't let friends drive drunk.
And There are 75 to 100 marchers from schools from throughout the area.
And let's take the opportunity to remind all of you who are out there that if you're going to be partying today or on St. Patrick's Day, to make sure that you have a good time and don't end it in tragedy. That's what these young people would like you to remember.
And there is our special band, Spirit of Windsor.
This is the third year in a row.
Third year for them. And last night, they were guests at Holy Rosary for a dance. And they stayed overnight in the gym there and made some fast friends.
Well, let's listen.
The Spirit of Windsor Youth Band, Windsor, Ontario. Representing the Syracuse Chiefs Baseball Club. Won't be long now.
Spirit of Windsor took first place at the Festival of the Tartans in New Glasgow, Nova Scotia last summer. And they were here last summer. They stopped by, and Kathleen Kelly of Project Children had a big party for them.
They do a fantastic job, and it's great to have them here. Here's another terrific float from the Octagon House.
Representing the float of the Octagon House.
And as a resident of Camillus, I can tell you just how hard the folks have worked there to restore the Octagon House.
Done to scale.
And there it is at scale, decorated for the holiday.
And it is a replica, isn't it?
Absolutely. They were very fortunate this year to get some special funding from New York State to continue that renovation. Very important to preserve the history of buildings like this all over Central New York, and those folks do a terrific job.
They're going to start their building, what, in the spring, rebuilding?
Yeah, they've already actually begun, Rick, and there are arts and crafts festivals there now. In fact, Betty Campbell and the folks from the Octagon House are doing a fantastic job. Camillus history lives.
Do you notice the shamrock trees on the Octagon House?
The Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade is brought to you in part by Falso Heating, serving Central New York for over 100 years. ET Video, your headquarters for home entertainment. And by Odunkle Bright, reminding you to shop their Irish Bargain Party. More parade festivities following these messages.
Since my wife switched her grocery shopping to Wegmans, mealtimes are more interesting, and our weekly food bills have gone down. Wegmans has lowered prices on lots of things we use every day for good. Take it from me, I'm a food expert, my friend. Now I can have my croissants and save money, too. Hey!
Savings add up at Wegmans. Every day you get our best. And the best is now for less.
If you need a car, there's something you need to know. Courtesy Ford sells more front-wheel drive Fords than any other dealer in Syracuse. And because we do, we're able to sell Fords for a lot less. And because we sell so many, you get the chance to choose from a huge inventory. If you need a car or truck, we have over 300 new cars and trucks available. Courtesy Ford, Route 11 at Route 81 in Mattydale, where you get the biggest selection and the lowest price.
Welcome back to the Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade, everyone. I'm Jeff Scheidecker along with Nancy Duffy and Rick Gehry, and it's just a great day down here in Syracuse.
It's a great day, and I heard Rod Wood just call out, if there's anyone cold, raise their hand. And nobody did.
Here's Charlie Roman. And Rick, what's he doing here, Rick?
I don't know, but I'll tell you something. I had a
Charlie Roman
doing that in broadcasting, and you can see where I wound up, right?
Charlie Roman's doing his famous chicken dance.
Chicken dance.
Renamed for this week, O Romans.
Chicken is remarkable. remarkable, isn't it?
Well, he's not chicken today, that's for sure.
Not to wear shorts.
Well, we've got, of course, Peggy Finnegan with us, and she is down along the parade route. Peg, what you finding down there?
Well, I have found myself the quintessential Irish police officer, John Patrick O'Brien. What a lovely name, John.
Thank you very much.
You must be proud of your Irish heritage.
I most certainly am.
What a cush assignment for an O'Brien to end up doing traffic control here at the parade. Enjoying yourself?
I most certainly am, and I would like to add that it appears that everybody else is enjoying themselves also. You know, a large crowd, they're very well behaved, and what more can we ask for?
Once in a while, you get revelers that get out of hand, but have you had any problems here today?
No, to my knowledge, in this area, we haven't had any problems with any of the kids, the parents. Everybody's very well behaved and appears, as I said, enjoying themselves.
Well, Officer O'Brien, you are doing a fine job. Thank you for being with us here today, and enjoy yourself. That's the name of the game. We'll go back to the reviewing stand now.
Well, thank you, Margaret. Miss Margaret Finnegan and Officer O'Brien.
There's
the accordion steel band from
Lean
Brooklyn,
green
New York,
machine
Nancy.
From St.
That's right. Let's listen to them. First time a Caribbean steel band has been in the St. Patrick's Parade.
That's fantastic. They do a great job.
I don't know if you remember, but that band was here at the State Fair last year, and that's when they first indicated they'd like to come back.
And St. Cecilia's CYO represented from Salve.
All right. Hello, gang.
Pastor Angelo Morbido and Associate Pastor Michael Minahan. St. Patrick's very special day at St. Cecilia's Parish, and really at every parish all across Onondaga County in central New York.
And now the float from the Carl
and we ought to put in a little promo here because we understand that the Durning String Band is coming soon, right?
That's right. They've already started on the parade route
featuring the
down by
theme.
The Clinton Square area, and we'll be seeing them relatively soon.
So you haven't missed them. If you joined us late, you have not missed the Mummers. Stay tuned. They'll be here shortly.
On a 9:30.
Another one of our terrific floats, and this is just beautiful. With a leprechaun and a huge shamrock, and look at those beautiful flowers. That's from Bosie's, I believe, Nancy.
That's the Bosie's float right there.
Just gorgeous. Sure to be a competitor for that trophy this year.
I'm sure, definitely. Of course, you know, Bosie's does give float training courses.
Of course.
In fact, they were telling our Mike Price that that might be a problem for them. They've trained so many other people how to compete that they can't run away with the prize every year, but they've got a beautiful entry this year.
And we're told the Mummers in Philadelphia will be here shortly.
And here are the folks from the Erie Canal Museum, Rick.
It's a new entry this year. That's a miniature Erie Canal wagon.
They're driving mules.
And there are a lot of Irish that got their first glimpse of the Salt City from the deck of a canal boat. The Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade is brought to you in part by Wegmans, where every day you get our best for less. By Chapels, the store that's always personally yours since 1895. And by Onondaga Beverage, distributor of Guinness and Harp imported Irish beer. And we'll be right back, right after these messages.
Chapels presents the Suits of the Season. Make a splash in tanks. Suits that are sassy. Suits that sizzle. Black and white. A stroke of color. Freestyle. High style. Low style. Styles that make waves. The biggest names in swimwear. Jansen, Sassafras, Catalina, and more. Go ahead. Make a splash. The Suits of the Season at all 7 Chapel stores.
This is Bill Cosby. My wife and I are packing to go on a week's vacation, and we are going to just have a ball. We're going to see wild animals, do some surfing, take the children to the amusement parks, see some of the historic treasures. We've got plenty of camping equipment, and we're going to go up in the mountains and do some walking. Where are we going? New Jersey.
For a perfect vacation,
Come to New Jersey. New Jersey and you, perfect together.
Welcome back to the Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade in downtown Syracuse. Jeff Scheidecker along with Nancy Duffy and Rick Gehry here on Central New York 9. And the parade continues, approaching the 7th Division, Nancy.
And the 7th Division is especially interesting because it does have the Mummers of Philadelphia, which are already along the parade route. There we see the ambassadors from Montreal that have, this is their, I think, their fourth year.
They're a drum and trumpets corps from Valleyfield, Canada. Parades all over Canada and the United States. They won trophies first, second, and third place last year. 7 to 21 years old, these folks are.
They liked it so much last year, they stayed for 4 days.
Quebec, Canada. Now, from Syracuse, O'Reilly's Raisins.
O'Reilly's Raisins. Now, these people are something. They are the original marching raisins. They got the idea from the commercial.
Huh? California raisins.
Here they are.
Well, if you don't wait for Canada, I better stand up.
Well, they're the O'Reilly Raisins with their Irish top hats.
The O'Reilly Raisins have improved since last year.
Well, everything gets better with age, Nancy. I guess raisins, too.
Yes, they were more like grapes last year.
There they are.
Okay. Okay. Want me to stand up? Okay.
Okay, gentlemen. Well, this guy is got to be familiar, Jim. To everybody, there's no doubt about it. I have to introduce you, but I want to tell you something. You did a great job with the weather last night.
Well, thank you very much.
You may have a future as a congressman. You may have a future as a weatherman. You've got all bases covered here.
Competition's a little tougher for weather, I think.
Well, whichever job you don't want, let me know, will you? Right, I'll be on the line here today. What do you think of parade today?
Oh, it's been a great parade. Just exciting and good weather and great turnout and a lot of spirit. Great day for the Irish.
A lot of Irish people in Central New York on a day like this.
Everybody's Irish today. The whole world's Irish, it looks like.
Who are these gentlemen we got next to us here?
Well, we're from Kitchener-Waterloo, sir, and we are the members of the Lion Lambert Accordion Band. This is our 10th year and our first visit to the USA, and we're thoroughly enjoying it.
Well, we're glad you're here.
And on behalf of Walter McLean, our Member of Parliament, we'd like to give this greeting to Tom Young, and to extend friendship from the Government of Canada, the Canadian flag, sir.
Oh, great.
And from the Mayor of Waterloo, Marjorie Carroll, also to Tom Young with this little gift, and from the Mayor, Dom Cardillo, of the city of Kitchener, this letter, and also this city of Kitchener crest. And we hope you'll think of us many times as you look at these, sir.
Well, we're delighted that our Canadian neighbors have come and shown this great support. There's many Canadians here as there are Americans, and we're delighted to have it. And on behalf of the mayor of the city of Syracuse, Tom Young, and the people of the city, welcome and thank you very, very much.
Okay. Thank you very much, gentlemen. We appreciate it. All right. There you go.
And thanks very much to Common Council President Jim Walsh, our Grand Marshal this year, along with his father, William Walsh. Well, Nancy, look what we see.
Oh, there they are. There they are.
The highlight of the annual St. Patrick's Parade, the Durning String Band from Philadelphia. What more do you need to say than the Mummers are coming, folks?
Here they come.
Marching into view.
That's right, the Mummers, of course, and that's Jack Key, the leader in front. And the Mummer Mama, who is our own Calhoun Ellis.
Mummer Mama, I like that.
Well, we have a Mummer Mama every year to specially take care of the needs of the Mummers. And she told us about 2 hours ago that the Mummers had broken down along the way, but apparently their bus was fixed and they arrived okay.
There's a lot of anticipation among the crowd for the Mummers and folks just waiting for them. And we're going to get a real opportunity to see them and hear them and watch them do their thing here on Salina Street for the annual St. Patrick's Parade. A little bit of the Mummers Parade right here in Syracuse today.
I want to see if they can do what they did last year, and that was bring the sun out again. When they came.
Actually, yeah. The clouds have cleared a little bit, Rick, and the sun is shining through.
Good possibility here.
These are fantastic costumes, you know, all of those feathers, and we always take a chance because they will not march if it rains. And you can see why. Certainly ruin their costumes, but there's not a trace of rain today.
They have a different type costume this year than they did last year. I notice they have orange chaps, you know, more a different costume. Of course, the feathers are always there.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, please.
And here they are,
Pennsylvania,
coming into view now.
The Durning String Band, a division of the Mummers.
They're cowboys, if you can tell. Have you ever seen a cowboy like that?
And we're sure
no, not really. But if I guess I were to be a cowboy, I'm going to look like that. Right.
Look at the artwork there.
Tough to mount a horse that way, though.
Looks a little bit Mexican, too.
Beautiful costumes.
They're Mexican-Irishmen.
And they know how to hold a crowd. They build up the suspense before they start.
And they're right in front of the reviewing stand now.
They're, of course, sponsored by the hotels at Shamrock Square. And there will be a concert after they perform in the parade right in the Imperial Ballroom.
Let's listen.
Of course, people are all in the hotel watching this parade.
The crowd that's gathered around the Mummers is just fantastic. They're not done yet. Let's continue to watch.
They're putting on a little tableau.
Coverage of the Syracuse St. Patrick's Parade is brought to you in part by PNC. When it comes to saving you money on your overall food bill, the price champion wrote the book. The Downtown Committee, where good things continue to happen at Merchants Bank. Let merchants get you in top financial shape. We'll be right back.
It's O'Duncan O'Bright time. I'm Patrick O'Bright at the biggest furniture sale of the year.
And you'll get our lowest prices of the year on the largest selection of furniture in New York State. Like this elegant cherry dining room or this cherry bedroom, both by Broyhill for only $977.
For the biggest furniture savings of the year, come to the annual Irish Bargain Party at O'Duncan O'Bright. O'Duncan O'Bright.
ET Video, entertainment to go. You'll find the largest selection of movies in Central New York in both VHS and beta formats. Check the new ET Video Guide. Most children's films are just 93 cents a day. ET has Nintendo game cartridges for sale or rent. ET is the source for all your audio and video needs. Cameras, large screen TVs, camcorders, and VCRs. All for sale or rent. ET Video is entertainment to go. Liverpool, North Syracuse, Brewerton, Mexico, and in Williams Grocery.
It certainly is exciting to watch today's parade in downtown Syracuse, but you know, you don't have to wait for a parade to enjoy a visit to downtown. There's lots going on almost any time. If you haven't yet visited the shops in Armory Square or ridden the new Salt City trolley, you may have missed part of the excitement of downtown. How about the new galleries on South Salina Street or the exciting variety of downtown restaurants? More than 200 shops are also located right here. Isn't it time you visited downtown again?
PNC presents The Big Book of Savings, a step-by-step guide to lower overall prices. Step 3, cents off label.
We buy specially marked packages direct from the manufacturer that give you an extra discount on your favorite brand names. You know it's a good time to stock up when you see a cents off label at PNC.
When it comes to saving you more on your overall food bill,
we wrote the book.
PNC.
And now, more of the Durning String Band, live from downtown Syracuse, the Mummers.
In Syracuse, you know, they love to come back. The first year they were very reluctant to come so far away from Philadelphia. Now they would be really disappointed not to come.
And Syracuse loves them too, Nancy. Listen to that ovation from the crowd.
Now, you say they'll be giving a concert a little bit later at the hotel tonight?
That's right.
Nancy, is that what the plan is?
As soon as they are out of their feathers, they maintain their other part of the country.
You must be out of your feathers before you can.
Well, once again, and there have been many highlights of the parade, Nancy, but they certainly have been one of the best that we've seen today. And that's saying something. We've seen some terrific things today.
This is interesting. A pot of gold from the Hotel Syracuse.
Look at that. That required some work.
And look at the lights on it.
Yeah.
Little candles
Very
up
nice.
There and candle lights and balloons.
And, of course, the hotels at Syracuse Square, as you said earlier, bringing the Mummers to the parade again this year.
And followed by some of the people that help with the O'Keefe School of Irish Dancing. There's a Weedsport firehouse, a few firemen, and the Weedsport band.
Now, we're a little bit behind things right now, folks, because the Mummers, of course, stopped along the way to enjoy, let the crowd enjoy them. So we're going to continue along here. The Weedsport Fire Department. Wishing all of us a happy St. Patrick's Day.
And there is our chief marshal. That must mean that most of the divisions are lined up.
We hope. And from Blessed Sacrament School. Well, there's an interesting way to see the parade. Look, Ma, no hands.
Boy.
Now the State Thruway Authority.
Live parade coverage is brought to you by our friends, New Jersey Tourism, New Jersey and you, perfect together. True Value Hardware, more than a name, it's their way of doing business. And by Puffs, Puffs Plus, first aid for your sore nose. Parade festivities will continue after these messages.
And the gang from Maley's.
What's on board there? Okay. Hardest Gunk City.
Cut your energy bills with a new Carrier central air conditioner or heat pump. Buy now with no down payment. Pay later. How much later? June? No. July? No. Not even August. You don't have to pay till after Labor Day. Then choose convenient monthly terms or pay the full amount with no interest charges. A limited time offer. Call today.
Call Falso Heating now for a free estimate. No payment until October.
Describe how bad it feels.
I've got a sore nose.
It's just the rubbing and the dripping and the sneezing and the wiping and the rubbing and the dripping and the sneezing and the wiping.
Introducing First Aid for your nose when it's sore from too much blowing. New Puffs Plus.
Feels like there may be something in there.
There's lotion. I feel it on my fingers.
A lotion.
It's the first tissue with moisturizing lotion. New Puffs Plus.
Well, it saved my nose.
Puffs Plus is much less irritating than my tissue.
I've never had an experience where you blow your nose and it feels so good.
New Puffs Plus.
You're on your way financially. You found a place where you'd like to be.
Get into shape. The time is now. Let Merchants Bank show you how. You're ready for fiscal fitness. You'll find it at Merchants Bank. The time is now. We'll show you how. We're first in fiscal fitness. Merchants Bank.
Welcome back to the 6th annual St. Patrick's Parade from downtown Syracuse. Jeff Scheidecker along with Rick Gary and Nancy Duffy. And we're nearing the end of our live coverage. The parade will go on for a little bit longer than this, continuing to look at some of the bands and some of the floats that are coming down. Nancy, again, a fantastic job.
And I just saw two Easter bunnies, so that must mean Easter is not that far.
Easter's at the end of the parade, yeah.
Here is another one of our bands from Canada. Specifically, a fife and drum corps.
I heard the word smooth as silk, Nancy.
Yes, that was the word from the operations chiefs, Mike Harrington and Ed Higgins, who have completed their job of lining them all up. And after last year, it's wonderful to hear that everything, after all their planning, that everything did go off like clockwork.
Especially in a parade and an event this large.
Well, there's so many factors you just can't control.
I know, I'm just starting to feel a little damp.
It's getting a little cool. The sun really is going.
Now, if you were to judge these floats, what would you say? What would you say was your favorite?
I'll tell you, the Bosse's float certainly was just beautiful. This float right here is gorgeous. Look at those flowers.
It really is. And the Éireann Go Bragh, of course, that means Ireland forever. And that is the Alexander and Alexander float this year. Wow, what a gorgeous thing.
I guess I did like the flying unicorn.
Again,
well done.
Definitely a contender again this year.
Very much.
But you know, the thing of it is, we've only mentioned a couple of the floats, and you had, Nancy, what did you tell me, 500 floats in this parade of one form or another?
One form or another.
And the truth of the matter is, they were all just fantastic.
Everything, and we really want to say something about the Syracuse Police Department, because they have really cooperated this year. They have helped with the crowds. They've kept them back, a job that is really impossible. There's really not the numbers of policemen to do as they do in, say, New York City's parade, where they have
tens of thousands of police officers.
But this year, it has really been a very safe parade.
Here's a 95X. Another one of our Central New York radio stations represented here.
That's their answer to the boom box. That's the rock box.
Well, Nancy, again, another terrific parade this year.
Well, I guess also I would like to especially thank Steve Cronquist. I know he's here someplace.
In the truck somewhere.
He's in the truck. He always is here from morning till the very end of the parade, and we really are deeply grateful to him for all he has done for the parade and for me and for allowing us to telecast this so that the folks at home can see it.
And we hope you folks at home have enjoyed our bringing this parade to you. It's something that we look forward to and involves, as I said last year, literally every department at Channel 9. Every person has something to do with it. Rick, final thoughts?
Final thoughts. What can I say? But we close another parade, the sixth one, the fourth one we've televised, and we look forward to another book of it next year, right?
We'll see you all next year.
Come in handy.
But the planning has already begun.
I bet it has.
All right, okay. It's a date. Well, for Rick Gehry and Nancy Duffy, I'm Jeff Scheidecker. We want to thank you for joining us today in our live coverage of the St. Patrick's Parade. Happy St. Patrick's Day, everyone.
Good morning to you. And I'll begin.